integrated pest management in sugarcane. About 220 insect pests and 76 non-insect pests ravage the sugarcane crop in India. These reduce the sugarcane yield by about 20% and sometimes drastically bring down the recovery in sugar factories and also affect the quality of jaggery produced. In integrated pest management, the pests are managed to remain below economic injury level by adoption of available technologies in as compatible and economic manner as possible, taking into consideration the ecological, economic and social acceptance. Among the borers infesting sugarcane crop, early shoot borer, that is Chyloinfeus catalus, is widely distributed in all the sugarcane growing areas in the country. The pest usually attacks during the early part of cane growth before internode formation. The borer larvae enter the shoot laterally below the ground level by one or more holes in the stalks and kill the growing point. Thus, it cuts off the central leaf spindle, which eventually dries, forming a dead heart. Intensity of attack by shoot borer increases in summer months if the crop is below 90 days old. Hence, in endemic locations, plant the crop before December to desynchronize the optimum crop stage with the optimum summer months. Light earthing up on 30th day, frequent irrigation and trash mulching also reduces infestation. Apply Lindane 20 EC or Chlorpyrifos 20 EC when the dead hearts are 25 per 100 shoots. Mix 50 ml of the insecticide in 10 liters water and apply to the leaf walls of the shoot by high volume knapsack or backpack sprayers. The 10 liter spray solution is applied to 100 meter row length in a 90 centimeter spaced planting. At this rate of application, 2 liters of insecticide and 400 liters of water are required. The internode borer Chylosaccharophagus indicus is a major pest of sugarcane in peninsular India. When the borer attacks the apical bud, the crop growth is abruptly arrested, leading to reduction in yield. It induces sprouting of axial buds and forms dead hearts and bunchy tops like top borer. Hence, the quality deteriorates. When jaggery is prepared from internode borer attacked canes, setting becomes difficult, or the color turns out dark. To control this pest, detrash during 5th and 7th month. It is the only borer to pupate outside the cane in the leaf sheath. So, detrashing removes the pupae, denying the site for pupation and exposes the dispersing internode borer larvae to avian and other general predators. Use pheromone traps from 5th to 11th month. 10 SBI trap 1 water traps are required per acre and the lures need to be changed twice at 45 days intervals, that is on 6.5 month and 8th month. The SBI trap 1 is set at 75 to 90 centimeters on 5th month crop and at 150 centimeters on 6.5 month onwards. Top borer Serpophaga excerptalis is a major pest of sugarcane in the subtropical India. It infests sugarcane during all the stages of crop growth. Tunneling the midrib, short holes on lamina and dead hearts are characteristic symptoms of top borer attack. In grown-up canes, the infestation results in sprouting of the buds, producing a bunchy top appearance. SBI trap 1 pheromone trap at the rate of 10 per acre is set 2 to 3 days prior to brood emergence. Trap height is 45 cm for young crop and 150 cm for grown-up crop. Chyloaudicilius, commonly referred as stalk borer, is a major pest of Uttar Pradesh, Haryana, Punjab and Bihar. In the infested canes, the damaged internodes show symptoms of reddening and sometimes emit rancid odor. Release Trichogramma chylonis at 2 cc per acre at 10 locations at every fortnight from 5th to 11th month of the crop. deploy pheromone traps SBI Trap 1 at 10 per acre from 5th to 11th month of the crop. The lures should be changed at every 45 days. Maintain trap height at 90 centimeters. Gurdaspur borer, Asigona steniellus, is yet another serious pest of the subtropics. The larvae feed gregariously upon entry into the top tender internode in a spiral manner, making minute punctures on the rind from within. Externally, the tunnel appears as a dark spiral made up of a series of punctures lying side by side like beads in a rosary. As a control measure, periodically collect and destroy the canes showing primary infestation. Root borer, Emalocera depressella, is the only species of borers infesting the underground portion of canes. It infests the young shoots and causes dead hearts. In the grown-up crops, no external symptom is seen except yellowing of lower leaves. Light hoeing around the clumps and earthing up block the exit hole of moths in the soil. The sucking pests infesting sugarcane include pyrilla, scale insect, mealybug and white woolly aphid. Pyrilla is one of the most destructive foliage sucking pests of sugarcane. The adults and the nymphs suck leaf sap from the undersurface of the leaves, resulting in yellowish white spots. The honeydew secreted by them encourage sooty mold growth, which hinder photosynthesis and give sickly appearance to the field. Redistribution and mass release of Epirikenia melanoleuca provides effective suppression of pyrilla. Scale insect Melanaspis agglomerata is a sucking pest of sugarcane stock. When the infestation is heavy, the entire stem is covered by the scale insect and its encrustation gives grayish-black appearance. Though there are three species of white flies infesting sugarcane, Allurolobus barodensis is economically important. The nymphs of white flies suck the sap from the undersurface of the leaves, which turn yellow and pinkish. Heavily infested leaves are covered by the sooty mold caused by the fungus Capnodium species, which adversely affects photosynthesis. Spray Malathion 0.1%, directing the spray fluids to cover the undersurface of the leaves. Repeat spraying after 15 days. Avoid blanket spraying of the entire field. The white grub Holotrichia species damage roots and underground stalks of cane in patches in the field. In endemic conditions, the entire crop dries. Collect adult beetles from host trees on the night of the first summer shower to subsequent 5 nights. Retaining or stagnating rainwater in fallow fields for 48 hours brings larvae to the surface, which can be collected and destroyed. Rice can be grown as crop rotation to eliminate the underground population of grub stages. The termites attack sets, shoots, canes, and also the stubbles soon after planting till harvest. It gains entry through the cut ends or through buds of the sets and feed on the soft tissue, replacing with soil. As a control measure, destruction of mounds in and around sugarcane fields can be done. The superstructure is demolished and a bund is raised around the mound. Insecticide solution 150 ml of Lindane 20 EC or Chlorpyrifos 20 EC in 10 litres water should be filled to saturate the underground galleries of the mound to kill the queen. In the standing crop, application of Lindane or Chlorpyrifos 20 EC in and around infested clumps may be done. The sets, particularly cut ends, may be dipped in Confidor solution 4 ml in 10 litres of water and planted to get protection against termite for 25 to 30 days.